Good morning, guys. It is Saturday, the 28th of July, 2018. It is day two of Yalc, the Young Adult Literature Convention, part of London Film and Comic Con.
You're watching nukemz.
Yesterday was a lot of fun. It's 5 to 9. Doors open at 9. I'm just heading there now from my sister's, so I'm going to be late, but nothing really starts till 10. That's when the workshops and the panels start. Today, I have 6 books I want to get signed. Last night, we had quite a few thunderstorms in London, and all over the UK, I think. So, it is nowhere near as hot, which is actually really nice, because it was getting to the point for Britain where it's a little bit too hot. And it's very, very windy and breezy, and just, it's a nice change after about 3 weeks of heat. Yeah, anyways, enough waffling. I'm gonna go get on the tube. Right, I'm here. It's about to go 10. There is no queue. Just gotta get through bag touch and then I'm up and in Yalc. So I've been having to wander about and I just realised that there's no panels I'm that interested in until 1 p.m. today. So kind of not sure what to do. I might go down to LFCC for a bit. My friend Ellie is coming to LFCC with her boyfriend Adam today, so I might go and see if they're around yet. They've put air conditioning on today, which is making me really happy. But also, I have such a heavy bag full of books that I can't really pick up any more ARCs. Maybe one or two, but not many. So the struggle is real. Yeah, just gonna have a wander about.
Place in a West African setting, so my short pitch for it is either African the Last Airbender or Black Panther with magic.
Hi everyone. So White Rabbit Red Wolf is about a 17-year-old math prodigy with severe panic disorder who gets dragged into a government spy conspiracy when there's an assassination attempt made on his mother, who's the most important strategic research mind since Turing. Yeah, it's been being described like Curious Since the Dog in the Nighttime meets Bourne, but not by me.
But no one really knows how to go about it. And that's how I was like 2 years ago. Before I was going to the Women's March, I was literally Googling, what do I take to a march? How do you march? Like, I had no idea. And so I think that can be really alienating when people don't know like the segue into it. So I just wanted to break it down and like give you like easy guides and prompts and just realise that, like, as you were saying, like, politics is everything, like, can't ignore it anymore. And you don't have to be scared of it. There's so many like simple things you can do to get involved.
I've sat, I've had some lunch, chilled out, and now it's panel time. Becky Chambers, Samantha Shannon, and Sasha Olsberg, and there's some others. I'm not sure who else, but it's gonna be great. I'm here with Lizzie.
She's back, and she has planet this time.
She has. Mm. And 3 books are up to be handed out.
I'm the author of the Wayfarer series, the most recent of which is Record of a Spaceborne Few, which came out this week. This book takes place in the Exodus Fleet, a setting mentioned in the other books, but hitherto unseen. It's the collection of generation ships that carried the remnants of humanity away from Earth hundreds of years ago. And this book takes a deep dive into their culture, their traditions, their way of life, and how it's all changing since first contact.
I'm the co-author of Xenith the Andromeda Saga, and my co-author Sally cannot be here today since she's growing a baby in her belly, but she says hi to every single one of you. Pretty much Zenith is taking place in the world of the Mirrorball Galaxy. It is about a crew of female space pirates who get roped into doing a rescue mission they do not want to do, but ends up having them have to go in and save a galaxy they kind of dislike.
Two NASA astronauts on their way to start a colony on a new planet, and en route her parents die, so she is responsible for looking after the spaceship all on her own. And after a while, she gets a message from NASA when she's 17 saying that a faster spaceship is launched, which is going to catch up with us. So she starts talking to the boy on board, whose name is Jay. And while they're talking, they find out that a war on Earth has cut out all contact with NASA. So Romy and Jay are completely isolated in space with only each other to talk to. And things get a lot darker.
Lindsay and I had a lot of fun playing around with. It's a vast galaxy, and in a galaxy such as theirs, which is quite advanced, a lot of other species from, you know, alternate galaxies and whatnot have come and mingled within their own. And it was really fun for us to kind of craft what is an alien and kind of taking that and expanding it within our novel. The first draft of Zenith actually really didn't have any aliens in it, and that's just because we didn't get to that point in the book where we would get to show you guys more about what this world actually looks like. You guys pretty much in the first 60 pages of it only got to see the inside of the ship and then, you know, them getting captured and whatnot. So it's really fun getting to expand on it later on. But something that I really enjoyed was not just creating aliens, but creating cool, like, you know, concepts in this book, by, like body modification. Our main character, Andy, she has these metal cheekbones because she got, just because they're cool. You know, it's a fun thing, and it's a thing that, you know, her being young, she wants to be different and unique because they're her.
That was an amazing panel. I'm now in the queue to meet Sasha Ginsberg, and it's a very big queue. And next to it is a really big queue to meet Becky Chambers. Hoping to get both my books signed for each of them. We'll find. So just under an hour in the queue to meet Sasha Ginsberg. I've got a picture. And she was really, really lovely. She genuinely is one of the people that inspired me to try and make more booktube videos. I then just went and met Stephen Camden, which was really nice. I didn't get a picture of him. It was really nice to meet him. I got my book signed by him. I've just got a queue ticket for Becky Chambers. I'm going to sit on the floor for a bit because I'm very tired. Changed my mind. I got in the queue for Becky Chambers as it seems to be going fairly fast. So, I got my book signed by Becky Chambers. I didn't get to get a picture of her because her queue was still really big. I'm now going to head into a panel that's been on for 20 minutes, but it's a chance to sit down for 10, 20 minutes. My body, my way. Let's see if it's good. It's got Laura Stephen in it, who's an author that I love, so it should be fun.
Obviously, the media is a huge problem, but just the way we treat each other is like even bigger a problem. Because if we really wanted to, we could reject these messages that were being fed. But like you say, like a lot of our first experiences with that kind of thing are with family or friends, or parents telling you to go on a diet and that sort of thing. And that, you know, like when you're 6 or 7 years old, that's so damaging. And by the time you start to internalize the media messages, it's too late anyway, because in your community there's always so much focus on that. And I went to a really small school, and like the boys, there were only about 20 girls in each year group, and they would rank them year on year based on like weight and appearance. And it's just like, how do you even begin to tackle that when it is so ingrained in not just the media, but in our communities and the way we see each other and treat sex in like chapter books? But I still think that there needs to be some kind of, because there are such huge gaps in sex education, we need to be filling those gaps somehow, just by discussing them. So, yeah.
Also, books are such a safe place to explore these things, so why not? I mean,
okay, it's 4:15. I stayed in that panel for a little while, but I've decided to head down to NFCC, have a little look around, see if my friend Ellie's here, hang out with her maybe, and then go and get something to drink. And just have a bit of a walkabout and a bit of a break from the Yalc. It's got to be done once a day, exploring NFCC. Well, I managed about 25 minutes, if that, in LFCC. It's so claustrophobic in there for me. I'm not going to get to see my friend Ellie, I don't think. She's down there somewhere, and it's so many thousands of people. I'm happy staying up at Yalc, but I'm going to come outside. I've just come outside, rather. I need some fresh air, and I'm going to head over to Tesco's and get some things to drink and something to eat. So I'm getting a little bit hungry, a little bit. Well, just round the corner from the entrance to Yalc, I found some seats, and I've literally just sat down for about 10-15 minutes. Took a few paracetamol, so I've got a headache, and just enjoyed a bit of fresh air. Now, I'm going to head back in. They've got a big Yalc quiz about to happen in about 5 minutes, so I might go to that, or I might just sit and see what's going on at Yalc, because it's been pretty fun.
3, 2, 1. All right, the team formerly known as Team Non, what is your new team name?
Team Momoa.
Team Momoa! All right. Team formerly known as Team Simon, what is your name?
Ours is Hey Ya, but spelled Hey Y-A.
Hey Ya. Guys, I hate to say it to any of the first point goes to Team Momoa. I got a big cheer.
Yes.
Sorry, Hey Ya. Sorry, Hey Ya.
Team said. And then this team has to guess it.
This could be so much.
People said this tweet. All right.
You can confer.
Yeah, you can confer. If you guys have to hide your faces, but yet you don't say it. In 2015, I had a bit of a career wobble and wanted to give up. Instead, I wrote several dreams I had of my future as a writer and pinned them on my wall. One of those was to collaborate with people who make me feel good. Today, the culmination of that particular dream is coming true.
Non-prod.
Yay! Who would have
Ten points if you fail.
He smiled about 10 points.
I love that he was probably trying to be subtle.
Points if you fail.
He smiled about 10 points.
I love that he was probably trying to be subtle.
Well, guys, that quiz was a lot of fun. I don't know if you saw, but just at the end of it, Jason Momoa, Aquaman, and Khal Drogo in Game of Thrones decided to come out once again. He's quite enjoying going through to the green room. He is this year's version of Benedict Cumberbatch. And it's the first time I've seen him over the whole weekend. And that was really cool. So that's finished. Don't think there's any other panels on. I'm just going to wander about and see if there's any more arcs I can maybe get. I don't know. Maybe some samplers. Let's see. Well, guys, it's 6:25. I've left Yalc for the day. It's been a fun day, very long. I've had a very heavy bag full of books. That's all of my books for signing for this weekend signed. So tomorrow I don't have to bring a bag full of books to get signed, which is awesome. It's been lovely to meet some authors that I absolutely adore. Lovely to meet Sasha Olsberg, who's a booktuber that I've been a big fan of for quite a few years. And to get my copy of Zenith signed, or my two copies of Zenith signed. Anyways, it's been a fun day. I'm going to head to my sister's and get some dinner on the way. But I'm going to end this here, so I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, smash that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. Let me know what you're reading at the moment in the comments down below. And I will see you for the last day of Yalc tomorrow. Bye, guys.
Subscribe to this guy for even more good times.